New study by researchers at the University of Chicago shows the impact vitamin D can have when it comes to COVID-19.
Joining us now to talk about the findings of the study is Dr. David Meltzer. Thank you so much for joining us. So it appears that a deficiency in vitamin D, there's a connection with COVID. Can you explain?
Sure. What our study did is examine patients tested for COVID at the University of Chicago and try to figure out whether patients who were vitamin D deficient were at increased risk of catching COVID compared to people who were not vitamin D deficient. And the way we approached that was by looking to see whether they were more likely to test positive for COVID when we tested them. And what we discovered was that patients who were vitamin D deficient were about 77% more likely to test positive for COVID than patients who were not vitamin D deficient.
Well, doctor, first of all, how do we find out if we're deficient in vitamin D and how do we get it? I know supplements and sun and fish and things like that, but people probably at home are saying, oh my goodness, let me get some right away. Let me get my hands on it. What's the best way to do it?
Okay, so first of all, you can be tested. You can go to your doctor and get tested. It's also possible to get home tests. However, for many of us, simply taking a supplement is a reasonable thing to do. There's a recommended daily allowance, which depending on your age is typically from about 400 to about 1,000 international units per day. The National Academy of Medicine has said that for most people, it's safe to go as high as 4,000 units per day. And so for most of us, we can take a supplement or expose ourselves on a daily basis to some sun as long as the weather permits, and that will help raise our levels even without being tested.
Well, I want to backtrack just a little bit. Now, this is the initial findings. There is more testing to be done. Tell us a little bit about what's the next step. What are clinical trials entailing?
Yeah, so what we found was an association. People with higher levels of vitamin D deficient being more likely to test positive for COVID. But that doesn't prove that taking more vitamin D will decrease the rates of COVID. And the only way to test that for sure is clinical trials. So we're in the process now of beginning some studies where people will have the opportunity to take different doses of vitamin D and see whether their risk of contracting COVID is affected.
Well, a lot of folks may be running out right now to go get some. Is there such thing as too much vitamin D?
Absolutely. Most people think that, most experts think that as you go up to about 4,000 units a day, you're okay. As you go up to 10,000 units a day, you probably should be talking to your doctor and maybe having some medical monitoring. And doses above that clearly carry risks of high blood calcium and other complications at very high rates that suggest that you should not go above those levels. So for most people, unless they're going to talk with their doctor, I would try to stay at 4,000 or below.
You know, we also want to be a little wary of this because you were quoted as saying this isn't a substitute for avoiding exposure. You can't just say, okay, I don't need my mask because I'm taking my vitamin D.
That is absolutely correct. This is something we can do that will help us, but the very first line of defense for all of us should be wearing masks, using appropriate hygiene, all the public health measures that everyone has been talking about. Hopefully this will be a valuable help in addition, but I don't think this should be something that someone takes and then imagines that they are protected, because that would be a serious mistake.
All right, Dr. Meltzer, thank you so much for joining us. Good luck on those clinical trials.
Great, thank you.